Hi, my name is Emily Neville. I belong to Community Church at Ocean Pines, and I'd like to share with you a story today called The Quilt. As I faced my Maker at the Last Judgment, I knelt before the Lord along with other souls. Before each of us had laid our lives, like the squares of a quilt, in many piles. An angel sat before each of us, sewing our quilt squares together into a tapestry that was our life. But as my angel took each piece of cloth off the pile, I noticed how ragged and empty each of the squares was. They were filled with giant holes. Each square was labeled with a part of my life that had been difficult, all the challenges and temptations that I had faced with everyday life. I saw hardships that I had endured, which were the largest holes of all. I glanced around me. Nobody else had such squares. Others had a tiny hole here and there. Other tapestries were filled with rich color and bright hues of worldly fortune. I gazed upon my own life and was disheartened. My angel was sewing the raggedy pieces of cloth together, threadbare and empty, like binding air together. Finally, the time came when each life was to be displayed, held up to the light and the scrutiny of truth. The others rose each in turn, holding up their tapestries. So filled their lives had been compared to mine. My angel looked at me and nodded for me to rise. My gaze dropped to the ground in shame. I hadn't had all those earthly fortunes. I had had love in my life and a lot of laughter, but there had also been trials of illness, death, and false accusations that took me from my world as I knew it. I had to start over many times. I often struggled with the temptation to quit the world, only to somehow muster the strength to pick up and begin again. I had many nights on my knees in prayer, asking for help and guidance in my life. I had been held up to ridicule, which I endured painfully, each time offering it up to the Father, in hopes that I would not melt within my skin beneath the judgmental gaze of those who had treated me unfairly. And now, I had to face the truth. My life was what it was, and I had to accept what it had been. I rose slowly and slowly lifted the combined squares of my life to the light. An awe-filled gasp filled the air. I gasped around at the others who looked at me with their eyes wide open. Then I looked at the tapestry before me. Light flooded through the many holes, creating an image. It was the face of Christ. Then our Lord stood before me with warmth and love in his eyes. He said, "Every time you gave your life to me, it became my life, my hardships, and my struggles. Each point of light in your life is when you stepped aside and let me shine through until there was more of me than there was of you. Welcome home, my child." Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for loving us. Thank you for always being with us in the good and the bad. Help our life's quilt be full of you so that one day we may stand in your glory and hear those wonderful words, "Well done. Welcome home, my child." Thank you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.